As the old saying goes, it's not what you make, it's what you keep. It has never been more true than today in 2019. There is a grand disparity in between the rich and middle class. Even though it continues to widen, there's one thing that is ultimately quite evident. No matter how much people earn, they tend to spend it all anyway. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Today we're going to talk about people that are making $300,000 a year and they're still broke. They have no cash. That's really the underlying message for the video. We're going to look at this chart here in depth, but I'm just going to touch on it for a moment and then we'll move back to it. Living a middle-class lifestyle on $300,000 a year in an expensive metropolitan area, the individual here from Financial Samurai breaks down all of those expenses that people have, everything, quite in detail, and essentially the cities in consideration. They're focusing on San Francisco, but also including areas like New York City and my favorite, Toronto. Why households need to earn $300,000 a year to live a middle-class lifestyle today. And I know many people would hear that and think that's crazy, that's absurd. How can this possibly be? Well, we'll look at it today. And although the individual here in Financial Samurai makes some points, he talks about his personal situation, talking about these individual cities, it's not going to apply to everybody. People are going to look at it and they're going to think it's ridiculous, it's crazy, and so on. But the point I want to make here, and I want to stress this right up front, is that whatever people earn, they tend to spend it. So for example, if an individual is making $50,000 a year and he finally gets that promotion he's been waiting for, and now he's earning $60,000 or $70,000, does he save $10,000 or $20,000 extra per year? Or does he now move into the better apartment? Does he now buy a house? Does he now buy a better car? Does he buy better clothing, go to the more expensive restaurants, and so on, and continuously wipes out that extra amount of money that he makes in his paycheck? And that is an absolute fact. That's what I'm getting at. No matter what people make, they tend to spend it all. That's the point of today, and that's what I want you to think about as I go through here. Not necessarily what this individual is saying, but just consider my underlying point. In order to comfortably raise a family in an expensive coastal city like San Fran or New York, you've got to make at least $300,000 a year. You can certainly raise a family earning less, as many do, but it won't be easy if your goal is to save for retirement, save for your children's education, own your own home, and actually retire by a reasonable age. All of these things are foreign to so many people today. We're talking about retiring at 65, 60, or 55. No way. That's for so many people today are finding themselves pushing that back further and further. First, they were hoping it'd be 55. Then they were hoping 60. Then 65 comes around. They're not ready. And so they have to push that off. A lot of people who want to continue to work, that's great. That's excellent. But for a large majority of people who want to retire at a particular age, whatever that is, they find themselves having to extend it. Maybe it's just 1 year. Maybe it's two. Maybe it's five. Maybe it's forever. Saving for your child's education. Imagine we've got prices that are continuously rising with college education. This is one very, very expensive thing to get into. There is no doubt about that. It is one thing that has been continuously rising as the years go on. Now, owning a home as well is becoming expensive, but hey, rents are too. Both of them are constantly an unaffordable category for so many people. And of course, what we have today is a situation where people are simply not prepared, and they are always thinking that everything is going to stay the way it is. I'm going to always have this job. I'm going to be consistently getting these earnings with raises at this much. My bonus at the end of the year is going to be this much. My wife is going to have this type of job. I'm always going to be going to the same areas. Nothing is going to increase in prices at the store. The electricity and energy expenses won't rise. I don't have to worry. And these things are simply a dream in people's minds because you have to look at the reality, and that is cost of living is continuously increasing. People are not able to deal with it. Although $300,000 is a lot compared to the median household income in the United States of $62,000, it's not an outrageous sum of money once you look at the realistic income statement I've put together for this article. He gets into his own situation, and you might disagree with a lot of what you see here. Maybe it's inflated on this or that. You don't agree with this. You wouldn't do that. You don't have this. But let's just take it for what it is. And remember, all I'm trying to get to is the fact that it's very, very expensive today to live, to do the basic things that we have. If you want any of those extra things that he mentions in here, those are also expensive. But I don't really worry about the particular numbers. I think it's senseless anyway. But we're going to look at some of these things and break it down and to see how somebody earning $300,000 a year spends all their money. At the bottom, half of the U.S. population lives on the coast. Therefore, this post is directly targeted at folks who need to live on the coast because of their job, school, or families. So you've got a lot of these places that tends to be where the most expensive homes are, the most expensive cost of living, but that's where half the population lives, in a bunch of cities, just a handful of cities. And so that's really what we're looking at here today. But it also extends out further into places around the world where we have these extremely expensive cities where there tends to be a lot of the population, whether that's Vancouver, Toronto, you can look at Hong Kong, Sydney, London, and so on. Now you might be thinking to yourself, $300,000 a year, what kind of job do these people have? Are they CEOs? Are they presidents? Well, not exactly. A Bay Area rapid transit janitor made $234,000 plus $36,000 in benefits in 2016. Now he's probably finding particular examples that are off the charts, but it's possible that you are working a blue collar job and you're making an extremely large amount of money. And the list goes on. You can see all of the different positions that are here. He pulls up a list. I just thought it was interesting because it shows you that you don't necessarily need to be the CEO of Facebook to be earning a very, very large sum. It could be coming from anywhere. So let's do a little digging into this income and expenses statement that they provided here through Financial Samurai. I wanted to show you this because it really breaks it all down, and then we can have a few discussions about this. And of course, as I said, you could argue one thing or another, not important, but it still shows you that these are what people are doing today. Let's look at it. At the very top, they're talking about your gross annual outcome of $300,000. That's $25,000 a month. $25,000 a month, right? You would think you'd be able to buy everything and anything. There'd be no reason to worry. Check this out. Taxable income after your 401k contributions, 21.8. So they're suggesting that people are going to consistently be contributing into their 401k. Also along with this is that these people are not saving any money other than their 401k and putting money down into their mortgage. That's it. That's all they're doing. They don't have any money left over. In fact, cash flow after expenses to pay for miscellaneous, $243 a month. That's it. It burns out everything they have. You can look at the tax bills that people have. That's about $6,000 a month. Looking at everything for a person that's making that much money, they're paying a lot in taxes, okay? Then you go down further into the expenses. Look at childcare and babysitting assistance for one child. What about when you have two children? This is very expensive. Monthly, it looks like it's about $2,400. That seems a little bit high. From what I can tell you in Toronto, it's usually about $2,000. But if you had two kids, just think about it. I mean, you're talking about $3,000, $4,000 for this type of care for children. Food for three. What about food for four, right? I mean, they're suggesting to you that if your family is only three people, what if it's two people? What if it's four people? What if five people? You know, these numbers are different for a lot, but it just shows you, for example, $1,600. That's including a weekly date night, $55. A day per month, it works out to $1,600. Mortgage, $2,000 on the principal, $1,900 interest per month, that totals $3,900. And we can go down some of the other things that I'm seeing here. You know, you got your property taxes, property insurance, property maintenance, life insurance, your umbrella, your healthcare, baby stuff. 3 weeks of vacation per year, some would argue on that. They just go on. Your car bills, your utilities, your phone, everything is listed in here. And it's so interesting interesting to see how all of that money, $25,000 per month, is evaporated. And now maybe you could go through here and you could cross this off. Maybe you don't need this. 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 It doesn't matter. When you look at all of this, it just shows you how somebody who makes $300,000 per year, every single year, $25,000 per month, they find a way to spend all of it. So when I see people who are looking at targeting people, maybe they're driving a Mercedes-Benz or something, and they're saying, look how much money this guy has. He has all of this money. It's crazy. It's absurd. He's a CEO of that company for sure. I know. But that guy doesn't really have any money. He's got things. Maybe he has a Mercedes that he probably owes $80,000 on. Maybe he has that nice house down the street, but he has a $1 million mortgage on it. Maybe he has a nice ring for his wife, but it was paid for on credit. There's no way to look at all of this and actually be able to suggest that these people necessarily have much more money. Now, a lot of what they're doing here, according to this, they're contributing to the 401k, they're earning a lot of income, but ultimately when it comes down to it, they don't have any cash. They don't have any other investments. This doesn't include stocks and everything else. People are spending everything they have. Doesn't matter if you're earning $25,000 a month or you're earning $2,000 a month. What I have found to be always true, no matter where you look at, this is Toronto, Canada, or you're looking at Sydney, Australia, no matter where you look in the world, people spend what they have on average. That's just what I have found to be true after speaking with so many people all around the world, different cities, and people do not know what's coming. I'm going to end the video there. If you found it informative, please give me a thumbs up. When you give me a like on this video, you are supporting me. You are supporting the truth. So I do appreciate that very much. If you want the financial education you weren't taught in school, it was left out of the school system on purpose so you wouldn't be able to find out, well then these two books have everything you need from top to bottom, from A to Z, foundation, history, asset classes, and everything else in between. Check it out at the link in the description. If you want the audiobook, that's available at themoneygps.com. People are leaving San Francisco. They're leaving California. You got to watch this video to get all the details. Click on it, and I will see you there.